Hey there guys, this is Chef Chris, and today we are making boudin stuffed bell peppers with a gorgeous spicy bell pepper sauce. Now these are great for lunch, these are great for dinner, these are great for in-betweeners, they're just a nice little snack. And actually they're pretty filling as well. Now these are not your normal ones that are made with just beef and maybe marinara sauce, which are delicious. These are actually made with boudin and a nice pepper sauce, a little twist, and they are great. Alright, so we're gonna get started. Instead of buying, you can buy roasted bell peppers in the store, and they're filled with oil. You know, they're still good, but why not make them at home? So much easier, so much less expensive, and why not do it? Alright, so we just got a red bell pepper I'm using for the sauce. I've used yellow, I used orange to make this sauce, I've used green, everyone is fine. As you can tell, I'm just slicing it up, I'm laying it flat, I cut the little edges so it just lays flat. I'm going to take out those membranes right in the center, all the seeds, and we're going to toss them under a boiler for 10 minutes, okay? Just leave them in there for 10 minutes, it'll be totally fine. While that's cooking, we're going to start with the ingredients. We have a red onion that we're chopping up, dicing. We got some jalapenos that we're using. We got like 4 slices of tomatoes, just give that little extra color and flavor. And we're going to nicely chop up about 2 garlics here. That's what I used. I love garlic. Maybe even 3 would be great. And we got some fresh cilantro from the garden we're going to throw in there to give that little extra freshness. All right, put those ingredients inside, and we are going to start breaking up this boudin. If you've never had boudin, I grew up with it as a little kid. It is great. People eat them in a tortilla just like this. It's more like, it's full of liver hearts, rice. It's got a couple of meats in there. It's delicious. If you've never had it, give it a try. All right, so we're going to throw in all the ingredients. We got the red onions in there, the jalapenos, the tomatoes. I believe the cilantro should be coming next. The garlic first, and then the cilantro. Perfect, there we are. And we can add something else that we didn't chop up or grate, which is cheese. I'm using the Fies blend, which is sharp cheddar and mozzarella. I love cheese in here, gives a little cheesiness, and who doesn't love cheese? All right, we're gonna season this, make it a little spicy. We got some fresh crushed peppers, and of course, we're gonna season everything with some salt and some fresh cracked black pepper. And first we're going with the cayenne, then we're going with the fresh cracked black pepper. And we're gonna give that a nice stir, make sure everything's well incorporated, and we are set with that. As soon as I'm done cracking this pepper, I like it, I love pepper. It's really good. All right, so we're gonna run to the oven. It's been 10 minutes. Those roasted peppers are nice and black. I could have given it an extra 2-3 minutes to get them a little darker, but they were fine. We're gonna throw that in a bowl and cover it with saran wrap. That's gonna help all the steam, all the heat that's in the peppers to fully cook those peppers and get them nice and soft, okay? All right, we're gonna start the prep work for the peppers that we're stuffing. I've said peppers quite a few times in this video. I cut the lid off. I like to leave the lid because we're going to cover it again. And we're going to take all the seeds, all the membranes once again, and we are going to stuff the peppers. Now, this is important. You want to go ahead and pack that stuff in there. You want to, not too tightly, but you do want to pack it, because while it cooks, this is actually going to sink down. So you're not going to end up with as much stuffing as it looks like now. It's gonna become a little less, okay? So you do wanna pack it tightly. Now this, I used 2 boudins, so all this made 4 peppers for me, okay? But actually right now I am topping it off with a little bit of breadcrumbs. It's gonna give it that nice crispy crust right on top, okay? I used regular breadcrumbs and I seasoned them with some Italian seasonings and some crushed peppers. All right, I'm gonna top it off with a little bit of tomatoes just to give it that color to add up with the pepper. And season it with some salt and some fresh cracked black pepper. And we're gonna throw that into a preheated 350 degree oven. I threw those lids right on top because the presentation, it looks nice. All right, we're gonna cook that for 1 hour exactly. Maybe 1.5 hours, depending on your oven, but 1 hour was good for me. All right, now that those peppers were steamed, we're gonna make this sauce. Here's a little trick to get the skin off. Cold water works best. You can use it under, you can just go under your faucet and pull it off, or you can just pour some water in a bowl like I did. It does take away a little bit of that flavor from the red peppers, which is not a good thing, but it does work. All right, I ran to the garden for the sauce. We're gonna grab a nice cayenne pepper that we have growing back there. I'm also grabbing some boxwood basil. You can use regular basil, you can use cilantro, you can use parsley, any kind of fresh herb to finish it off. All right, while we're gonna make that sauce, like I said. So we got a white onion here. Didn't go red, I used white here. And you don't have to be too careful here. Just roughly chop it because we're going to blend it afterwards, okay? All right, so we, same thing with the garlic. I just gave it a nice rough chop. No big deal. Don't have to be precise here. And the same thing with that cayenne pepper. All right, in a saute pan on about medium heat here, I threw in a nice big squeeze of extra virgin olive oil. And we're going to throw in those white onions. Of course, we're going to season everything with some salt and some fresh cracked black pepper. And we're going to saute this for about 2.5 minutes, just until they become nicely soft, a little translucent. At that point, we're going to lower the heat to about medium-low here. Just because we're throwing in the garlic and the red peppers, and there's nothing worse than burnt garlic. So I like to turn the heat down just a little bit. Cook those for about 2.5 minutes again. Turn that heat up a little bit and throw in those red peppers. They are beautiful, delicious, nicely roasted. And I do like my sauces to be spicy, so we're throwing in some crushed pepper. Love that cayenne. And we're going to finish it off with some chicken stock. Vegetable stock would be great too. If you don't have anything, I guess water will work, but a little more flavor. You can add, if you don't like it as spicy, you are the boss of your sauce. As you know, I do like mine spicy. All right, about 5-10 minutes later, when everything was nicely incorporated and that flavor is gorgeous, I'm using an immersion blender, okay? If you don't have one of these, you should buy one. But if you don't have one, use your margarita maker, also known as a regular blender. Blend that up nice and smooth. Now, I do like to strain my sauce here because it does have a little bit of pulp in there and I don't like the pulp. I am Christian. Oh, well, maybe. I don't know if that makes sense, but I don't like pulp, so I do strain that, okay? We're going to throw that back on the stove. If your sauce is a little watery because you put too much chicken sauce, don't worry. Boil that down just a little bit. It'll thicken up, no problem. I finished off with a little bit of cream, as you saw. I got those beautiful basil leaves, tossed it in there, and we were done. I put that bell pepper, surrounded it with that gorgeous sauce. It's so crispy on top. Delicious. Oh, I love these. It is amazing. All right, guys. Well, that was my roasted boudin stuffed roasted bell peppers with a great spicy bell pepper sauce. If there's any recipes you guys would like to learn how to make, let me know. And as always, I hope you guys enjoy.